Welcome to GeoMind. This is part 2 of the video Evolution of Earth. GeoMind is a channel focused on subjects geography, geology, and earth science. Students who are preparing for various competitive examination can find this channel helpful. So if you like this video, please subscribe to the channel and share this video. Also comment down below what are the changes I need to make to videos look more professional. Thank you. So let's start. As in the first video, I have already discussed the origin of Earth and how it evolved. So in this lecture, I will talk about the origin of atmosphere and origin of oceans. So let's first talk about atmosphere. Atmosphere, as you know, in present time consists of various layers of gases. But in primitive Earth, the composition of atmosphere was not like that which is present today. Okay, it was consisting of basically hydrogen, helium, methane, ammonia, and carbon dioxide, and water vapor. That's it. There was no free oxygen. Okay, no free oxygen at that time. But oxygen was present only in water vapor form. Now, in primitive atmosphere, the lightest of gases such as hydrogen and helium apparently escaped, because at that time Earth was just starting to form and gravity was too weak to hold them. So most of the remaining gases were probably scattered into space by strong solar winds. So apart from hydrogen and helium, there was pretty active solar activity, because we are talking about 4.5 billion years ago. So at that time, even sun was in its initial phase. So T-Tauri phase is known as the early phase, during which solar winds were very intense. Okay, so a sun was in its active stage of early evolution. So but with time, the first enduring atmosphere means that atmosphere which remains on the Earth with very long period of time. Okay, so the first sustainable atmosphere was generated by a process called outgassing. This is very important phenomena, and it is mostly asked frequently in various examination, that the first atmosphere was created by which process. So it, process is known as outgassing. Outgassing basically happens via volcanoes, because volcanoes are the landforms which spew out or which throw out the trapped gases within planet's interior. Okay, so as we have discussed earlier, that water vapor, carbon dioxide mostly was the composition of primitive atmosphere, but free oxygen was not present. Okay, and these water vapor and carbon dioxide was probably a product of hydrous minerals, okay, which contained these volatiles material, and such as amphiboles. Okay, as you know, amphibole contains OH group. So as mineral material or gases spewed out through the volcanic winds, these gases began to accumulate into the atmosphere. Now, as you can see in this image, this is the primitive artist description of primitive Earth. These are the stromatolites, and this is the volcano, and the gases are spewing out through the vents. Now, oxygen is atmosphere, because why we are talking about oxygen, because oxygen is the second most abundant gas right now. So it generates question that right now is the second most abundant gas, but in primitive Earth there was no signs of free oxygen. So how did oxygen came into play? As you know, as Earth cooled, water vapor condensed to form clouds. Now, we were talking about free oxygen, but water vapor was still there in H2O form. Okay, so torrential rain began to fill low-lying areas, and which became oceans. Now, in those oceans, nearly 3.5 billion years ago, photosynthesizing bacteria began to release oxygen into water. Okay, so what happened? There was water vapor from the volcanic vents. Then through time, as the Earth's temperature decreased, water vapor condensed to form clouds. Torrential rain begins to flow into low-lying areas, and there was shallow seas. And about 3.5 billion years ago, photosynthesizing bacteria then began to release oxygen into water. And during photosynthesis, as you know, sun's energy is used by organism to produce organic material. Okay, so most of you might know the reaction, that how photosynthesis reaction works. So the first bacteria probably use hydrogen sulfide as a source of hydrogen rather than water. As you know, one of the earliest bacteria, cyanobacteria, called blue-green algae, began to produce oxygen as a byproduct of photosynthesis. Now, initially, the newly released oxygen was readily consumed by chemical reaction with other atoms and molecules, particularly in the ocean. It seems that large quantities of iron were released into early ocean through submarine volcanism and associated hydrothermal vents. As you know, iron is an element which has tremendous affinity for oxygen, and you can see rust in every part of the iron oxide. Okay, so you can find rust in everywhere, so it means that iron has very high affinity for oxygen and it easily get oxidized. So early iron oxide deposits with chert is called banded iron formation. So banded iron formation or Archean formation, Archeans mean that it formed around 3.5 billion years ago, and this was the few of the examples which shows that oxygen came later, okay, in the Earth's history. Now, as the ocean formed, we will talk about how it evolved, okay. Now, primitive oceans were rich in carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and hydrogen sulfide. It means that earliest rainwater was highly acidic in nature. Okay, there is this one fact that earliest ocean was acidic or neutral in nature. So it was acidic in nature. The current pH of ocean is around 8.2, right? It means slightly alkaline. And with the time, Earth's surface weathered at an accelerated rate. Okay, and with the time, as Earth's surface was weathered, various molecules or various substances such as sodium, calcium, potassium, silica were carried into newly formed oceans. Now, some of these dissolved substances precipitated to become chemical sediments that mantled the ocean floor. Okay, so in ocean floors, these suppose this is ocean, and this is ocean floor. So these ions get precipitated here through time. Suppose this is a rock, so it started to get weathered and accumulate in ocean floor. Other substances form soluble salt, which increase the salinity of water, such as sulfates, chlorine. We know chlorine is the most abundant ion in the ocean. Now, research suggests that salinity of the ocean increased rapidly first, but remained constant over the last 2 billion years. As you know, 35 ppt is the current salinity of ocean, parts per thousand. It means that out of 1000 parts, 35 parts are salts. Salts mean sulfates, chlorines, okay, potassium ions. Now, Earth's oceans are also serving as the depository. That means they store tremendous volume of carbon dioxide. A major constituent in the primitive atmosphere was carbon dioxide, as we have discussed earlier, carbon dioxide and water vapor. This is significant because if oceans were not there, this carbon dioxide will be not trapped into those oceans, and our Earth would have runaway greenhouse effect. Okay. Now, here I will take the example of Venus, as Venus is similar to Earth, and it is also known as sister planet of Earth, and it has a carbon dioxide atmosphere which is 97% carbon dioxide. Okay, and has produced a runaway. Runaway means a greenhouse effect that can't be controlled. And its surface temperature is very, very high, that is 475 degrees Celsius. But as we know, carbon dioxide is readily soluble in seawater or water. You might have drank carbonated drinks like Coca-Cola or whatever, and they have carbon dioxide present in it. So carbon dioxide is easily soluble in water or seawater. So our oceans trap huge amount of carbon dioxide. But as the Earth evolved, the most common compound generated by consuming carbon dioxide is the calcium carbonate, okay, which makes the limestone and most abundant chemical sedimentary rock. It is the most abundant chemical sedimentary rock. It doesn't mean that the most abundant sedimentary rock is limestone. It is shale. Okay, so there is a difference between shale and limestone. Limestone is chemical sedimentary rock and shale is clastic. So shale is the most abundant, but if we talk about chemical, then limestone is the most abundant sedimentary rock. Overall, igneous rocks are the most abundant. So about as we know, so as we were talking about carbon dioxide in oceans, and this carbon dioxide present in the ocean formed various precipitates. Okay, and the most common precipitate is calcium carbonate, and about 542 million, that is in when a Cambrian explosion, in there was Cambrian explosion, marine organism began to extract calcium carbonate from seawater to make their cells. Okay, so as you know, before Cambrian, that is in Proterozoic Archean, there were very few animals, or very few organisms. But after Cambrian explosion, there were animals whose shells were of calcium carbonate, so they started to make shells from this calcium carbonate and form other hard parts. This is it for today's video. If you like this video, please like it and subscribe and share. I will make more videos like it. Thank you.